That's why. Check, check, check. Check one. Can you hear me now, Sam? Check one, two. All right, everybody, welcome back. What a way to start the Bones panel. Welcome to Wizard World virtual experiences as the crowd emojis wildly. I know I said that before, but you couldn't hear me. So I want to see all those emojis. We are streaming to you completely free and completely live on Facebook, Twitch, and YouTube to the comfort of your home, trying to recreate that convention lifestyle for free to the comfort and safety of your home. So thanks for tuning in. We have folks watching from around the world, everybody. We have folks tuning in from UK, Mexico, Spain, Indiana, New Jersey, Colorado, Michigan, Russia, Sweden, Estonia, Australia, Scotland, Hawaii, Germany, Seattle, Belgium, Austria. Austria in the house. We are very excited to bring out the cast of Bones in just a few minutes. But first, some quick housekeeping things. This panel is completely free, but there are some paid experiences you can interact with as well. Just head to wizardworldvirtual.com. Again, that's wizardworldvirtual.com to purchase those one-on-one video chats, live recorded messages, and autographs from all these amazing cast members. Tamara and Ignacio will be doing theirs directly after this panel. So if you want a one-on-one video chat with them, definitely purchase it now. But if you're watching this a little bit later in the week, don't worry, there are plenty of opportunities with the rest of the cast at wizardworldvirtual.com. Also head to the vault, wizardworldvault.com. We can't do physical conventions right now, but we're trying to do our best job to support our local artists and vendors. So go check out memorabilia, signed posters, art from all of our favorite artists and vendors from our physical conventions and past virtual experiences. Again, that is at wizardworldvault.com. All right, let's do this. Let's bring out this cast. We're so excited to have them here. I just finished rewatching some of my favorite episodes from all 12 seasons. And hey, everybody, it's the 15th anniversary of the premiere of this show. So we're very excited to bring some of the cast members out here from Bones. First up, let's bring out forensic facial reconstruction specialist at the Jeffersonian Institute. She is Angela Pearly Gates Montenegro Hodgins. Let's hear it for Michaela Conlan. Michaela, thank you for being here. Thank you for popping out. Yeah, let's get everybody out. Thank you all for being very quiet while we experienced some technical difficulties. You were very good. Very nice job, everyone there in the background. Let's keep the cast rolling. He is entomologist, botanist, mineralogist, king of the lab, everybody, Dr. Jack Hodgins. Let's hear it for TJ Thai.
Hi, I'm Michaela. Hey, Mike.
Hey, what's up? Welcome, welcome. Good to have you out here. We got four more to go. She is the head of the Jeffersonian Institute's Forensic Division, coroner, autopsy specialist, Dr. Cam. Let's hear it for Tamara Taylor.
TT.
TT. This is my favorite part of these panels, is just the awkward sort of popping out here, but it's so great. Yeah, we're here, we're here. Let's keep it going. He was a squintern. He was a doctor. He was an apprentice to a cannibal. We know him as Dr. Zach Addy. Let's hear it for Eric Milligan.
Eric. Eric.
Hey, I'm the real king of the lab.
Yeah,
There's gonna
you
be a
are.
battle brewing.
You are. You are. I think Dr. Jack gets it in last. He said, I think it's like one of your last lines, TJ, right? In the final episode.
Mike, I'm utterly impressed with how much you know about this show.
Yeah, I watch it. I watch it. I love it. It's a great series. I went back and watched a bunch of my like favorite episodes, and I'm excited to have you all out here. So I'm nerding out as much as I'm moderating at the same time. So
That's good.
it's great to have everybody. Let's keep it going. Federal prosecutor, our favorite federal prosecutor, works in the U.S. Attorney's Office, Caroline Julian. Let's hear it for Patricia Belcher.
Patricia.
Squints, yeah, nice. Already digging in on the squints, Patricia. My gosh, my gosh. I like it. Staying in character. And last but certainly not, speaking of squints and squinterns and doctors, joining us, lover of chainsaws too. I feel like Dr. Rodolfo Fuentes. Let's hear it for Ignacio Soricchio.
Hey everyone, can you see me? Ignacio's forehead. That, that's how my dad FaceTimes.
I know. That's like. That's what I'm saying. Like, that's like the uncle that's like, hello. And then they put it to their ears. Like, no, it's FaceTime.
I thought you just changed your look when we saw that cute little puppy in sunglasses on. I thought that was you now.
I know. I went from blonde to this.
This, man. Let's dive right in. We have, well, again, I don't know if you heard me shouting out all the countries that people are watching from around the world. We have folks
Indiana.
Watching. Yeah, like the country, the country of Indiana. Eric mentioned this right before we got on, and we actually had some fans also in Twitter that reminded me last night that today, I don't know if we did this on purpose. I hope someone thought of this, and actually it is on purpose, but the 15th anniversary of the premiere, my gosh, the show ended, what was it, 2017? Like, so just 3 years ago today. One of the longest running TV shows of all time, 12 seasons, 246 episodes. That's like Supernatural territory. You know, that's like you only needed a couple more seasons before you beat out Supernatural. My gosh, again, fans watching from around the world, not just the US, but in Canada and Mexico, but like, you know, Europe and Australia and Austria. My gosh, I just want to go around a little bit and just say what it means, you know, to be part of the legacy that is Bones. Again, one of the longest running TV shows of all time.
You're still in your trailer, right, TJ?
Yeah, I'm here now. I thought you guys were coming out any second. Are we not shooting?
No, we're not on the lot.
No one told you, huh?
Oh, honey, you're there all by yourself.
Yeah.
Gonna go now.
Okay. Always take your plant with you. Always take your trailer plant with you.
Wait, can I just say, and I know we're going to go around and say lovely things.
Yeah.
Eric, I can't believe you knew that. You're like the encyclopedia of all things Bones. Do you know that Eric?
I used to be able to name like, all the episodes in order.
Yes.
I think I can do like 10 maybe.
Let's go.
Yeah, what season, Eric? What season do we want to do? Okay, like season one? Season one. Go for it.
Boy in the Tree, Man in the SUV, Man on Death Row, which was the third episode we shot, but it then got moved to the middle of the season.
Oh my God, you know that.
Man and the Bear, Boy in the Bush.
Oh yeah.
Man in the Wall.
Oh yeah, Michaela, you were dancing.
That's about as far as I got.
Oh wow.
That's dancing incredible. At an event, at a party, at a club.
Pretty good. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. And I mean, you have the advantage, I guess, of all the titles have like similar sounding names, right? So you just have to remember the blank in the blank and sort of like what murder.
Notice how there. All the victims are men. Notice how all the victims are men. We're so stupid.
Well, there was women in
Boy,
the airport.
The man. It's just all
women in limbo.
Yeah. Yeah.
Woman in Limbo, one of the fan favorites for sure. My gosh, so much happened in that one. Let's keep talking about that. Let's keep celebrating it. My gosh, not only the titles of the shows, but just the series in general. And Eric, that's pretty impressive. You know, 22 episodes per season, except I know there was a couple like short ones in there, a couple 12 episode seasons. But yeah. Just talk about being part of the legacy. Again, it feels like it just ended yesterday. It's been 3 years now, but then a 12 season run. I mean, what are the memories like? Some of the fans that are asking right now, Catherine Buescher, Cynthia Vespia, just are, you know, curious about your favorite part, you know, of being part of the Bones legacy.
Well, my favorite episodes were the Christmas episode, which was called Man in the Fallout Shelter.
Yes.
It completely inside in the lab. Nothing was shot on location. It was all in the lab, which was very fun. Kind of felt like a play a little bit. And then I think it was second season. It was called, it was definitely second season because Tamara was in it. The aliens in the spaceship.
Yes.
Which is funny, if you go back to that, there's a scene where I figure out where Hodgins and Brennan are. And I say, I know where they are. Oh, and then I push Tamara out of the way. I'm like, I know where they are.
That for years. Literally pushed Dr. Soroyan down.
And you saved us. Thank you.
Tamara, you do a really good impression of me. Show everybody.
Oh yeah, no. We're all on the platform, and we're, you know, screens up, and we're all calculating and tabulating, and all of a sudden, Eric's character says, "Wait, I know where they are," and he literally pushes me.
You're like,
okay, that's cool. I'm just gonna get up and laugh after you.
I have a really cool photo of all of us in the dirt when we were all sitting around. You guys dug us out.
Oh yeah,
we're all sitting.
There were bees there that day too.
Oh my god, you got buzzed. Oh, yeah. Got stung.
Killer bees, man. You.
I got stung. Remember, we were like Wu Tang.
you got in trouble and you got stung.
I think that they knew it was us. Like, we were the most afraid of them, and that's why they went after us.
That scene was incredible. TJ, talk a little bit about, you mentioned being under the dirt. That scene where you guys are literally like exhumed from under the gravel. Like, what did they do? Like, how did they set that up?
No, we really dug down about 8 feet and they buried us. We like to do things really natural on this show. So Emily and I were down there for the whole,
with your little straw. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
all right.
I don't remember, Eric. Do you remember? I mean, I think they just dug a little bit and kind of covered us, but
Emily had a stunt double. I don't care. Did you too? I definitely remember Emily having one.
Yeah, no,
that's
right.
TJ, they didn't care.
Yeah, they're like, he's fine.
He'll be fine. He'll be fine, guys.
What stage did you shoot that on? Because I remember
it was outside.
Half of it was open, but you were sitting in the car lunch. You wouldn't get out of the car. You were just sitting, like, you know, sort of immersed. But ironically, the whole side of the car was open.
Yeah. Yeah, I stayed in the car the whole time. That's right. Yeah. I'm cuckoo.
Yeah, I'm cuckoo.
That was a fun one. I think it gets back to what Eric was saying about, like, the Christmas episode. There's something really lovely for us actors, when the space and the story is contained, then you have to get really real, and it's really nice. When it feels like you're always having to kind of dance and do a big scene, then it doesn't necessarily feel like you're as intimate. But when you have like a show where you're locked in together, or in that particular episode, it's nice. It just, you feel like it really is just the people working with you.
Well, talking about a Christmas episode, one of my favorite ones was when Caroline gets Booth and Brennan to kiss. You know, have this, my whole little scheme is like, she wants me to make it so that her dad can have Christmas in jail.
That's right.
And so I'm like, okay, well, you have to do something for me, you know, because I'm feeling kind of peckish, whatever. But anyway... I thought it meant hungry, but anyway.
Hungry for you. Hungry for somebody to make
it. Yeah. So, and then, you know, I still have a picture, because the way the, you know, they shot it was, I'm in between, and you can see them going to kiss, and my face is in between them, looking like, oh my God, they're doing it, you know, kind of stuff. I love that. It was really sweet.
Yeah. I mean, we count as fans. I know we counted down to every Brennan and Booth kiss. So those are important moments, you know what I mean, in the show. And Caroline's such a great character. You know, we have the squints and everybody works for the Jeffersonian. But to have that, like, poke the bear character, you know what I mean, that federal prosecutor that can kind of stir things up and really question the doctors, you know, was such an awesome part.
I kind of fussed at him one time. That was one kind of early on in. When I came in was, we were all in a cafeteria waiting for, I think, a verdict in a case. And I just kind of fussed at each one, like, you know, Zach let himself get blown up and did some poison and this did a blah, blah. What do you guys, you know, you got degrees and stuff. How come you don't, what do you take care of yourself? You know, it was fun though. But and what I remember working with, especially the gigglers who know who they are, and working on scenes, thank you. And one of our favorite directors, Jeannot Zwark, you know, and talked about working, but, you know, because I knew whenever I was gonna have to come and work with you guys, it was giggle.
You're talking about Tamara and myself.
Yeah. Well, it's funny. So, Patricia, I'm going to put you on the spot. Jade Miller actually is asking the question right now, who got the giggles the most while filming? So I think we got the answer already, TJ and Tamara, yeah?
Pretty much. Like, no, it was like, you know.
So hard not to go down.
But it was just this type of, but this cast, I mean, everyone is so funny, honestly. And so, Ignacio, there was a scene we did. You were like in this giant...
Was it garbage?
No, it was just
wet. There was like you were in water. I thought you had to like you had goggles. Like,
yeah. I still have that picture, by the way. You were in like I think we were digging through sewage, and you had like some kind of
yes, that
dancing around.
Yes, but this whole cast—it was one of these things where
I remember
it was so.
I remember the. I remember. I think it was my second episode, and we're doing where the big guy that. You lift the sheet, and it was the big dummy. That, and in the private part area, the dummy had some kind of. Every time Tamara lifted the sheet, we're supposed to be very serious. It was like, look, it was just we couldn't cry, and I couldn't look at any of these three right here because I was like, do not. We got to look past each other or look at the forehead because every time that sheet would come up over this fat guy's thing and Tamara would look at the private part. Oh my gosh.
I had the big line. I had to go right in for it. I couldn't by the end of it. I was just like, look down.
I love
but
this.
But there was also that element, like, where on this show, I mean, you do a lot of different shows, right? Every set is different.
Sure.
This one, it was like they would be literally counting down us. It's what just happened with you and us. You'd be counting down that the scene was about to start. Okay, we're rolling. Okay, you know, check. Okay, ready. And you would get down to like the millisecond before they said action. And we're all still laughing and joking. And then we would just drop it all and get right into the scene. And then as soon as they said cut, we just went right back into it. Never seen anything like
that. My favorite was when, the monkey. I personally, I almost got fired because I couldn't keep it together. I was supposed to. We were investigating these endangered animals. There was like some ring where they were like, you know, I don't know. These people were importing like, you know, exotic animals.
Right.
And that little monkey, for some reason, he was like. And so like, I'm looking at him and he's just too adorable. I'm supposed to have this serious moment. And for some reason what the monkey's doing is completely different. So they eventually had to cover my food, and I could still see him.
They covered it just enough, but he would get to the end.
And I was laughing so hard, I was crying. I thought they were going to fire me on the spot. Get the giggles. It's gone. It's gone because I love when people are talking like that, so that they don't laugh. When you can feel the laugh coming on, and you're trying.
And you feel like you will never. Get through it. Feel like that's it. There's no way we're gonna get the scene. And you're like, everybody's so mad. The crew wants to go home. But the thing is, unless
dead babies, dead babies.
Dead bit. A lot of dead things. Yeah, a lot of dead things.
It's a chemical thing. It's a chemical thing. It takes.
Oh, do you remember putting the gloves on?
You're done.
Do you remember putting the plastic gloves on? We had to so confidently put on those rubber gloves.
Yes.
And sometimes the scenes were really long.
They were like this.
You had to commit to having these gloves that were like really crazy. Like you couldn't take it off and cut. You had to just commit to that. Oh my God.
Plus, I was so nervous that that was going to happen. You started sweating.
I love this. As fans, we're like, oh my gosh, like there's a dead person on the table. Like this is really serious. And
bloody. I was worried about the gloves.
It was always the worst, but inevitably in the scene, you'd have to reach for something. Yes. So you've got this claw.
With your crab claw.
Everyone else knows. Everyone's watching your hands. Like everyone else in the scene.
Everyone knows.
Exactly.
I feel like Eric mastered it. Eric, did you master the glove putting on technique?
I think I somehow would always look for those opportunities where maybe Zach didn't need to wear gloves. So I was really good at like, no, I don't think we needed the gloves for this scene.
That's amazing.
I don't remember having any problem though. Because sometimes your hands aren't in the picture. So it's like, oh, we don't need it.
Yeah, my gosh. Michaela, you were starting to say something a little while back, just about when we were talking about like favorite moments or favorite episodes. I don't know if you remember what you were chiming in with.
Yeah. Oh, I think I was saying about the man in the Fallout show, that what TJ was referring to with all of us shooting together. Those episodes were always really fun because the show was really sort of split. You know, Emily and David would oftentimes be out on the field and we'd be in the lab. So when we were all together, those were sort of rare and very fun to do because it sort of felt like that our set was really wonderful and very big, and it was just sort of felt, it had a different feeling to it, those episodes. So that particular one was one where we all shot together, but there was a few more. I think like the finale, the weddings, the funerals, a lot of that stuff.
Very cool. I want to get to some fan questions here. This kind of ties in with what we were saying, you know, how there was, you know, so much like serious science things going on, but then just the fun that you were having. But this comes from Terry Peters, and also Daniela Schmelzer asked us a similar question. Terry Peters is watching from Australia. It's 3 a.m. right now, and they are up for this panel.
Terry, go to bed.
Terry has to work in 6 hours, but woke up because she loves the show so much, or they love the show so much. It's part of the reason they followed a career in science, as they love the portrayal of characters showing women in STEM. So this is a question for everybody, but let's start with the women. What was it like? She asked specifically, do you understand the science behind what your characters are talking about, or was it all confusing? So, you know, what was it like kind of learning the science and also, you know, representing women in STEM, which is really what the show is all about, are those strong female characters, I think, you know?
Well, it was always cool that, you know, a little fact is that the women's offices in the show were much bigger. I don't even know if TJ, you didn't have an office, right? Oh, you had the, but
yeah,
right.
Yeah.
Eric, I took over Eric's little cubicle.
I called it the Ookie room.
Yeah, they shoved us in the Ookie room, but no, we didn't have offices.
Yeah,
the women had really big offices in the show, which I think is sort of something kind of, you know, unconsciously that becomes sort of interesting over the seasons. But they gave me all the drawings before it turned to computer. Someone would draw those sketches for me and hand them to me, so I was never really learning to do that.
Wait, what?
We retained nothing. No, we had an amazing technical advisor as well.
Donna Klein,
she'd give us like a wonderful little legend for every episode. So
she wrote a book for every episode.
Pronunciation guide.
Wow.
Exactly. Oh, yeah.
Donna, appreciation. You knew what you were saying. I don't know how much of it we retained after the episode, but you definitely had a sense of what's going on. And if you, like, for whatever reason didn't, it, like, when you were approaching a scene, we just kind of look at Donna and say, is this good what I'm saying? Is this good? Is this good or is this bad? That's as simple as it got sometimes.
It is really inspiring, Mike, that like, and I think this goes for all of us on the show, anytime someone comes up to you and says, I watched your show when I was a kid, I wanted to get into forensics or some type of science, and now I am a yada yada. And it's just, it makes you feel so good that something you did to kind of tell stories and inspire people actually did just that. And seeing young women kind of take that field over and become these strong, powerful doctors now, that we had anything to do with that is incredible.
Yeah.
I think at the final party, Jonathan, one of the producers, didn't he go through like how many people were named Temperance in the 15 years?
Wow.
Like about how so many people were named Sealy and Temperance. That was greater amount than before we did the show.
So wow,
that's so cool.
I was on a plane going to Atlanta, and there was a nuclear physicist, and it's funny because I wouldn't have guessed that she was a nuclear physicist because she was a little tipsy on the champagne. She came over and she said, "I gotta tell you, I'm celebrating. I'm nominated for a Nobel Prize," and I was like, "What?" And she said, okay, not to be a weirdo, but I'm such a fan of the show. I'm a nuclear physicist, and all of my team is women because of you guys.
That's so cool.
Yeah, and yeah, that's literally, cool. Yeah, really amazing. And she was up for something really, really, like, you know, world-changing.
Yeah.
Know? And I think that's what sets this series apart from other, you know, police procedurals and why it lasted for so long was the attention to detail, the attention to science, the attention to the characters. You know, it wasn't just, you know, the standard like, oh, you know, let's like you really heard you all talking about the things and people Google like looked it up and you felt like you were learning and participating along with you, which is super amazing. Electra Midnight, TJ says that they are a zoologist and loved all of TJ's scenes. Wonder how easy or difficult it was for you to learn and pronounce all the scientific names. I know we talked a little bit about this, but yeah, what was that like having to spout out all that?
We had it easy with Google, right? We had it easy by the time the show, because when we first started, it was just a little bit harder. But as time went on, I mean, you could access things so quickly. But there was definitely an element of the show where you would work for 12, maybe 15 hours a day sometimes. And then you went home and you had homework. I mean, other shows you do, maybe you go home and you're learning lines, but this was homework. I mean, you had to do a lot of research to be able to know. And because our audiences were so smart and they legitimately were, you couldn't fake it. You had to know what you were talking about. So
I faked it. I had no idea what I was talking about. My goal was not necessarily to know what I was talking about, but to look like I knew what I was talking about.
That's an actor. That's an actual.
Because you can know what you're talking about and not look like
you. You guys were able to pronounce everything because, you know, I would get tongue-tied with, you know, sometimes, I don't know, sometimes the writing would be like, I remember one time I had some speech that had this, the super spies were in the cellar with the systematic system of the, and I was like,
yeah, and you're like, it's on purpose.
Yeah, and so all the stuff, but all the kind of medical and, you know, scientific nomenclature that you guys had to say was, you know, I just say, bow down to you for, you know, getting through that and acting through all of those, you know, hard.
My favorite work. Was Dr. Nithigali and Tetranychus Ortici. There's an episode where
favorite line. Jade Miller asked, "What's a favorite line?" I feel like that's your. Oh, Bones Jefferson asked for favorite lines, TJ. So I think you just said yours.
Being in the lab. there's an episode where Angela like. She starts spewing things off. Do you remember this, Michaela? You start spewing it and I think
I feel like they did that to be like, should we start having her do more? And they're like, you know what? No.
instructions. Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
you leave her in the computer part.
That's true. You did great. But it's such a great moment where I think you'd like, you've been hanging out with Hodgins a lot. Or you say hanging out with Hodgins way too much.
And I feel like this winter came in always had a lot of technical.
Oh, they always gave them brutal dialogue. I feel like TJ got the worst of it, really, because you were so good at learning it.
Yeah, no.
Well, Ignacio, you came in. We were talking about like there was like that kind of rotating cast of squinterns, right? That kind of came in and some stuck around for different moments. Some died tragically. Ignacio, what was it like coming in sort of with this crazy, crazy cast in like, what was it? Season 9, I think your character comes in, maybe season 9 or 10.
Yeah, I came in, you know, for me, it was I had been a fan of the show when we moved to the U.S. with my family. We watched Bones.
That's cool.
I loved the show. And then when I got to LA, I would go to auditions and I would run into Pej. I ran into Mike. And I would always run into these guys and say, hey, I'm a huge fan of the show. Good job, whatever. And then I was doing, an episode of The Finder, which was with Michael Clark Duncan. Yep. You guys remember that?
Yeah.
And I did an episode of that where I played a Cuban chef. And so that was done. And then I was in Belize. I was in the jungle in Belize doing a survival course for about 3 weeks. And I come out, I hadn't checked the internet, nothing. And I look at my emails and I had 100 emails from my manager saying, hey, they're offering this role on Bones. And it's incredible how it happened. So I had a connection to the show indirectly long before I got cast.
Wow.
I was a big fan of the show. I loved what you talked about. I loved the fact that it was such a balance between the male and female characters.
Yeah.
It was, I don't remember another show that so early on, just, it was like, no, this is how it is. And we don't need to beat it over the head. They're just badass women. They're very smart men. And it is what it is. It all came around and it was, yeah. And then, you know, I met these delinquents and it was even better.
Perhaps because that kind of jungle and came to hang out with us in the real jungle.
It was the best. I mean, from day one, I think all my scenes were with Tamara and Emily, and we have pictures from that day, and we were just silly immediately. Yeah,
well, I remember thinking, God, he's so handsome. I don't know. Be cool, man. He's really handsome, this guy. And then he showed up and he was like the biggest dork. And I mean that in the most, like in the like, it's the biggest compliment I can give you. You were such a dork. It's like, I love this guy. I love this guy. He's as foolish as he's handsome.
It's crazy.
I think I knew I was going to get along with them, because when you have people get along, it comes across on screen. There's no,
yeah.
That's just the truth. They've asked Scorsese, they're like, what about all these films that didn't do well? Why didn't they do well? And he said, it's because I had a problem with the producer or my cast didn't get along. And that's it. That's the key, right? If you have people, if you get along, it just comes across. And that's why this show did as well as it did. Because these guys got along.
We got along too good. We had so much fun on that show.
We really did.
Yeah, to the point of, exactly, yeah.
I really do. I said this recently with all of us, but there really are two, it's a bizarre thing where you have these two different paths of memory. One is the show itself and the things in which you did, and the other is the behind the scenes life that you lived for 12 years. And that is just something I will always be so grateful for, to be able to hang with all of you for that long.
Yeah, listen, my Mike, Eugene, and Pej, we've become so
that's
close.
Friends, I love that.
We became incredible friends, and there's something that everyone here shared. There was a sense of humility between everybody, and everybody was so respectful of each other, and we knew how lucky we were to be working, and that never changed. And that was just
And it also never stopped us from bitching about things. Never stopped us from bitching.
And what's incredible about it is even when it ended, you know, as fans, we could have watched, you know, six more seasons. It could have kept going on and on, even at 256 episodes, you know, there was still
people come back.
Well, you know, Eric, that's a good segue into a question from a fan. Corinne Boren asked it. Monica Nova says, would you be interested in coming together to do another season? I've rewatched every season over 20 times and would love. I know this person has watched it 20 times. Corinne says, like, a 2-hour movie. It would be so awesome to see you all together again. I mean, obviously, I know that the answer is probably a straight yes, of course. But, like, what would you be excited about returning? You know, like, what would excite you about returning to the series or returning to the characters?
Well, if they had me back, it'd be cool to see Zach back in action.
Yeah, back in society. Yeah.
I think it just would be fun to get to hang out with y'all again. That would be, to me, that would be the draw.
Yeah.
That
would be fun. I'm busy.
bigger deal.
I kind of miss those times, like Sweets and Booth, you know, the three of us would have a scene, and before the scene, you know, we're all dancing, and you know, they're going
David would make that
those we're all dancing. And one time we were doing that and the scene and we're, you know, then it's, you know, action, and we do our scene. And then the camera is like in front of us and it goes past because it's going up to the lab, you know, up to the platform. So the scene, and I'm off. Thank God, because right at that moment, my skirt dropped to the floor.
Oh, are you kidding?
Absolutely. You never saw me move so fast.
That's incredible. Talk about a massive wardrobe malfunction.
And I was like, did anybody see that? Because all the attention, the camera and everybody was behind me now.
Oh my God.
It was just that, I have to say though, I have had that accident a few times. yes, King's clothing has just fallen away, you know. What do they call that? Wardrobe?
Malfunction. Yeah. Laura,
if we came back, maybe Cam would have a baby, right?
Mm-hmm. Hey,
well, I know women have to have a baby. All the women have to have a baby at some point, right?
That would be so rad. But Cam adopted two or three boys at the end of the series. So
yeah, that's great.
Oh, and didn't you have a child before that too?
Yeah, but she was an adopted child from my first marriage, and she's grown up.
They can all sleep in Eric's room right there. He got bunk beds.
I know, definitely.
Yeah, what if instead of like a big like production, like a TV production, it's just like a very small, like intimate shoot in Eric's bedroom right there? Yeah. We bring the whole cast back.
This is my niece's bedroom.
That's amazing.
TJ McKella, other things you would come back, be excited to come back for character-wise, or like storyline-wise?
I mean, I'd be so interested in how they bring everybody back. You know, like what I'm always... Whenever they do those sort of like, you know, reunion things, I always find it really interesting to see like what they're going to come up with to find out. How to come
like
back.
JFD was at a piano bar and you were an artist in Paris and Gay Paris.
I was in Paris doing street caricatures. I love that like Angela had like no credentials. She had no degree. She was literally like sketching on the boardwalk. Solving crimes, you know?
Yeah. Like, she was making cartoon
characters. I was like drawing with a sketch pad and they're like, you come
help us solve crimes at the Jeffersonian.
I should have gone through my scripts before this and shown everyone what they really looked like when you were sketching.
Oh, Michaela's sketches, one of the best things ever.
Angela could get into politics easily.
Oh my God. Right. Yeah, no, they got rid of the sketch pads. They were like, let's move you digital because this is
not this looks a little weird. Wait, guys. What did you think?
Exactly.
I have like a quill pen. Terrible.
Oh, remember when they did that photo shoot of us and we all got our props and I kept getting black hand. What did you get, Eric? Yeah, you got a spider.
I had a spider on my hand. Yeah, that photo came out really well.
It was so cool. Better you than me.
It should have been a billboard in Times Square.
It was really cool. TJ got, I think, a magnifying glass or something.
Yes.
You had your sketch pad.
Trusty sketch pad.
Trusty sketch pad.
That was like the last photo shoot we ever did.
It kind of was. And I had this black prosthetic arm that just for some reason kept on landing. We did a photo shoot twice and I was like, the first time I thought, okay, the black prosthetic arm is maybe just an accident. And so I held it and we're like on these light tables. I held it and what ended up happening is it just made me look like I had a really long arm, which was really kind of strange. But that was the prop I was given. And then the next photo shoot I had, I was like, seriously? The black prosthetic arm again.
Was it really?
Yeah, I came twice.
Oh. She crushed it. She crushed it with that arm. Give it to her again.
She's so good.
She's so good at holding it.
I'm looking for her now.
Look at it. It looks like I have the world's longest left arm.
I think that picture was on one of the season's DVDs.
Mm.
Yeah.
And we were all on one of, there were six DVDs. And our picture was on each one. And I was like, oh my God, I've never been on a DVD before.
Isn't that cool?
I called Tamara and I'm like, pick out the sixth DVD.
Amazing.
And it was your picture. And I called Michaela too.
I remember that.
Yeah, you kept the spider, Eric.
Look at the third DVD. Yes.
looking for that picture, Tamara, there are so many stunning photos of you out there in the world.
Oh, dear God, no.
They're amazing. This is amazing. I haven't Googled you in a while.
That's a lesson in red carpet moments gone wrong. Oh, yeah.
Hey, this is amazing.
Oh, TJ, be careful with your mom's computer and what you're Googling and searching on there. Yeah.
I'm wearing my mom's computer.
Remember when we had to grow the skull?
That was so fun.
Oh, yeah.
That was another one.
I can't find
you know what was not fun? Dead Man's Party. That was one of the most awkward promo. Wow. I was like, hey, we've got a good idea. Let's dig up a song from the 80s. And let's all just dance around and do these like weird things with
then they have to turn the music off and you have to dance to like a oh my god, it's
which
so
by awesome. The way, if anyone knows what a click track is, there's no music, there's just a
the metronome.
You're trying to maintain your rhythm, so when people are looking crazy, it's because there's no music. We're dancing to no music.
Well, what's worse is when you're shooting something,
yes,
and you have a song and you're dancing to that song, but then they don't get the rights to it, so they put a different song comes out, and you're like, yes. I look terrible. That's not what we were trying to do.
I was actually on the beat. I had some rhythm. This is ridiculous.
Sometimes when you do a scene with music, you have to, they play the noise, but then you have to talk over the music, even though the music isn't playing.
Oh, that I'm so not good at that because you end up talking like this, right? Yeah. How exactly. are you doing? It's really cool. Yeah, no, nice to see you here too.
If you all revealed right now that Hot Blooded wasn't actually the song that Booth and Brennan were listening to every time, it would just crush fans around the world. Imagine it was like never that. It was never that song. It was like something else they were listening to.
It was like Hot Crudded, you know? It was like, it was the one that they could get the rights to.
Yeah. We were joking around about props and skulls and, you know, so many props on this set, and fans always want to know, specifically Patricia Lachelle, if you have anything. TJ, you mentioned some scripts with some beautiful artwork on it. but is there anything you all took as a memento once the series had ended? Everybody. Eric,
this was Caroline. Outfit.
Oh, that was a Caroline costume.
Oh,
nice.
You walked away with the Caroline outfit.
Wow. I walked away with the Caroline outfit.
The one that fell to the ground.
Our chairs that we sit at before we go on set, like
got it.
The director's back of the seat that says our names on it. I took one of those.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
I took mine and my badge. That was all I could think of. Because what am I going to do? A speculum? That seems weird.
I took the set. I've got the lab in my backyard.
So you took the whole thing, the whole ookie room?
Yep. Yeah.
Nice. Remember that weird bloated fish that was in that jar, just expanding as the years wore on? Yeah. I was like, is this guy real?
Ignacio took our hearts.
Even with that mug, with that face.
Yeah. Throws really good parties.
I took some stuff.
You did?
Oh yeah. Yeah, I took some stuff. Oh. I always take stuff. Yeah, I know. I took my lab coat. I took
what?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm really good at stealing stuff from sets. I'm not kidding. I'm really good. I've stolen stuff from my current show that's
amazing.
Like, they're not gonna
yeah.
They gave me stuff. My character had really good shoes in the first couple seasons, and I kept going on about how much I like them. And at the studio and the network, they have people called talent relations, and they're generally like to make you like to make the actors feel good or whatever. And they got me the shoes as a birthday present.
That's adorable.
Yeah, that's amazing. Ignacio, I picture like you have a secret room in your home that like is behind a vault door.
I do have a room in my house, which is kind of like my, that I turned into kind of, you know how Planet Hollywood or Hard Rock Cafe would have.
That's what I picture, yeah.
So I have all my scripts from everything I've ever done signed. You know, I had everyone here autograph my script. So that's all framed. And all the souvenirs that I took are hanging somewhere or yeah, it's a really cool, it's a, like a little cool media room.
If any of the cast members ever go missing, someone go to Ignacio's house and check that.
Yeah, exactly.
That's an that feels like an episode of Bones. You know what I mean? Yeah. There's, yeah.
We love them so much.
A villain, the villain that steals the thing from the. Yeah.
I would totally buy that TJ has the set in his backyard.
Yes.
Because exactly. he throws really extravagant parties.
Oh yeah.
I would run a poker game at my house on the weekend, and then I'd get everybody to go to TJ's house.
Oh yeah, because he'd have a movie party.
One day I randomly wore pajamas.
I remember.
Oh, yeah.
Halloween party.
That's right.
I was wearing pajamas that day and I was like, why don't I wear them to the party? But you would have a popcorn machine and a cotton candy machine and all these trees, and TJ knew how to throw a party.
Yeah,
I was never invited to any of those.
Angels, women wandering around, you know, with trees.
Yes,
like
yes, yes.
Yeah, it was amazing.
So you should have a party with that set you have in the backyard.
Yes, Ignacio, you're always welcome.
I never. I told you, I never got my invite. Maybe it got lost on my MySpace page. I don't know.
Madness Genius 04 said we want a party at TJ's, and that they would show up. The fan would show up. D3.
Well, his address is.
Yeah. D3 at G0D1. Crazy handle is just says they're tearing up at how much they miss you all. The fans are just having so much fun. I recommend going back and watching the chat, because just all the people expressing their love for the series and how much they miss it and how much they want it back. The outpouring of love is truly awesome. We're out of time. I want to get to a couple more little things here to get some other fans in. Shout out to Katie Sneed and Stacey Forrest. They asked kind of similar questions about, you know, favorite storylines, favorite memories. So thank you for sending those questions in. Also, a reminder, if you didn't get your question in or you want to have more individual one-on-one time, those one-on-one chats are going on right now, right after this, with Ignacio and Tamara, and then with the other folks a little bit later in the week or next weekend. So definitely take advantage of that once-in-a-lifetime experience at Wizard World Virtual. We've got one of the best villain twists on this panel right now, Eric. You were a part of it, and I know that who was the person that asked the question? asked, like, what was it like being involved with that and that twist? And then Catherine Busher also asked, favorite bad guy, favorite villain or bad guy season?
Well,
so we've got Graves.
Sorry, real quick. Real quick. Say hi, real quick. Oh, hey, say hi to everybody, Paige.
Hi, my TV husband.
That's awesome.
Who is that?
Really, that's awesome.
The twist was really cool.
Is that Eugene? Is that Eugene?
Are you serious?
Tell them to come say hi.
Get them
come
the link.
Say hi,
getting up.
Get them the link. Get them the Zoom link. I'll let them in. They're watching football. I can tell. That looks like football watching poses.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow.
That was it. I got it. I'm doing a panel with our, you know, we care about our fans. I'll call you. Baseball's not a sport. I love you.
That's awesome. That's awesome. That was Eric. The question actually came specifically from Todd Tremper about being cast, you know, the twist of the villain reveal.
Hey, Todd, you know, we were there was the writer's strike going on.
Yeah.
So I started touring the country following the Portland Trailblazers. And one day I got a call saying that Hart Hansen and Steve Nathan wanted to talk to me. And so they went to schedule a meeting. So I scheduled the meeting. And then I thought, no, I'm not waiting for this meeting. So I called Hart, and I was like, and he was like, no, we want to talk to you about it on the meeting. And I said, please tell me. And he told me that Zach wasn't going to be a regular on the show. So then I was like, okay, we're having our meeting tomorrow. I'm coming back.
Nah.
So I came back, and then they sat me down, and they're like, you're Gormagon. They didn't even say I was Gormagon's assistant first. They're like, you're Gormagon. I'm like, wait, I've been eating people? No, you haven't. And then the next twist, the next season, was that I didn't kill anybody.
Yeah.
I remember him telling me that twist as well.
That was so
But it was very exciting. And I loved the fact, you know, even though I was not going to be on the show on a regular basis, I was really excited about the character work they were giving me. So those last two episodes I got to do at the end of season three were like really, really fun as an actor.
That's amazing. I remember reading that script because it was the first script back from the writer's strike, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
It was our first episode of that next season.
Yes.
And we weren't warned. I don't know if TJ and Michaela were warned, but I wasn't. And maybe it's because I was brand new. But I read the episode and I was like, what's happening here? What's happening here? And I think like I called you immediately, Eric, and said, do I have this wrong? Because no one's told, like, this is crazy. Made me cry. That's for real.
I remember that.
We're moving on. It made me cry.
Telling us, TJ, I can't remember.
I remember talking to Eric on the phone. I was in Texas at the time. So I was in Austin, and I do remember we chatted about it. So I don't remember if it was an official thing that we got notified, but it was very sad.
Anytime Emily called me just to check in with me after that happened, because I guess Hart had just told her to. And I was just telling, you know, Emily, obviously I was, you know, going to be sad about leaving the show and working with you all. But apparently I wasn't that sad on the phone with Emily. So then I got in trouble for that. Like Hart was mad at me. Like we were talking about something. He was like, you weren't even upset that you were like not going to be on the show. And I'm like, no. They're like, you weren't upset to Emily.
So no, I was
excited about the acting challenge.
Yeah. Oh. God.
The return is great.
You got to come back a few times, which was really
so nice.
The shadow, the coming from out of the shadow shot from like, I think it was the
I finale. Love that story.
Yeah.
I was just so excited to come back. And I basically, when I left, I was like, I want to be in the 100th episode and I want to be in the finale. And I got both those things, which was exciting.
That's so cool. Yeah. That's so cool. Zach and Sweets. Those are the two biggest, I think, like tear up moments, you know, from the series. Yeah. My gosh. This is super, super awesome. Amanda Tyke. I remember when the pilot aired, I was at the mall with my dad. I made him take his shrimp basket and eat it in the car on the way home, so I wouldn't miss the episode. And I've never missed an episode in the 12 years, since. Thank you all so much for being here. This was so amazing. We could talk for hours about the show, and we could watch the show for hours because there's 246 episodes. And I know people are now like re-going back and re-watching it again for the 20th time, Monica Nova, or folks watching it for the first time again because now it's streaming. So I just want to go around the room one final time before we end and just hear a little bit from everyone. You know, just a final shout out to the fans, like, you know, what you're working on, how you're doing, and then we'll kind of wrap things up. I'm just going to go in the order of my screen. So Ignacio, final words or shout outs to the fans watching. Sorry, put you on the
spot. This was one of the greatest experiences of my life, and I genuinely love these people, and I love the effect that the show had on everybody, and I hope everyone's, you know, staying safe and trying, you know, to get through all of this. We're all getting through everything together, so I just want to send everyone a lot of love.
Awesome, thanks Ignacio. TJ.
You speak of fans. I think I'm just such a legitimately like honored fan of everyone on the screen and everyone we got to work with on the show. I'm so proud of all of you. Anytime I see you guys in other projects, I'm jumping up and down. It was really a family and it was a true team. So I miss that with all of you, but I'm so happy when we get together. In terms of all the fans out there who tuned in today, like Terry in Australia, go to bed. Thank you for taking the time to come here today and letting us have an opportunity to get together again and just kind of shed some love to each other.
Yeah, awesome. Raven 1973 said, this is a dream. I'm missing the Packers right now for this. So that means something when people skip out on sports to, you know, tune into their favorite shows. That's awesome. Eric?
I just think it's really exciting when I hear about people who become forensic anthropologists or currently studying. And I mean, people who watched us when they were a teenager trying to decide what to go into college for are now in their 30s. And they are forensic anthropologists, or they are, you know, working in that field. And I just think that's really, really cool. And congratulations. And thanks for watching our show.
Very cool. Thank you.
Or cannibals.
Or cannibals. They were so inspired by Eric's portrayal. No. Patricia?
I just want to thank everybody. Thank you guys. It's so good to see you again. I'm so happy to be reunited briefly. Yeah. And thank all the fans. I've just been amazed by how far reaching, you know, well, first of all, television, but the Bones show the fans that they've reached all over the world, you know, because I've had, you know, people write, and also I have the ability to travel in the past few years, and people in different countries, you know, that are just really great Bones fans. So thank you. Thank you, all of you. And I hope to see you guys really soon.
Yeah.
Awesome. Awesome. Yeah. Thanks, Patricia. Tamara?
Oh my gosh. I have to say that this show was one of the most extraordinary experiences of my life. We literally all grew up together. 12 years is a long time to laugh, a long time to love, a long time to learn. And the fact that our beautiful fans, you know, followed us from time change to time change,
yeah.
Night, managed to stay with us for that entire 12 years is just such an honor. Who's someone left?
Michaela was like, I'm done with this. Yet.
Really boring. I'm about to leave.
Yeah. So no, I'm just so grateful. Just so grateful to the fans for being with us on this incredible journey.
Awesome. Thanks, Tamara.
Thank you, guys.
And last but certainly not least, Michaela.
I was just gonna sign out.
Yeah.
I love that. Like the expert is like the one who like can't sort of. I mean, everyone's really said it. I will always feel so incredibly fortunate to have been able to be a part of something that went for so long and to work with such special people. It really is two things that don't happen in this business, and that, you know, I think all of us that have been doing it long enough are aware of that. And that's so cool. And then we have these fans that have grown up watching the show. Like, I agree with what Eric said. I have girls come up and say, I'm studying science, and it's because of you guys. And that's just so cool. We have wonderful fans, and it was just a wonderful experience. So yeah, love it.
Awesome. You're awesome.
Look forward to talking with you guys in the one-on-ones.
Yes, yes, yes. Good segue. Eric, you're great with the segues, Eric. Great with the segues.
yeah. Get to talk to you in the one-on-ones, Eric.
Thank you all so much again for being here. I know I speak on behalf of all the fans. There's hundreds and hundreds watching from around the world on three different platforms right now, just giving those heart emojis, shouting out what their careers are. And I know, I know, I know. I can maybe I can't screen share, but definitely go back. Definitely go back and check it out. But the fan love is adamant out there, and I just want to speak on behalf of all the fans and say thank you for doing this. So I know we're all having this crazy shared world experience right now, and you know, to be able to take some time off, like a little break, and just, you know, have some fun with y'all has been a pleasure. So thank you all so much for doing this. And let's give one more big round of emojis. Fans watching from around the world, all the Bones fans out there, whether you're watching it for the first time, the 10th time, the 20th time, we appreciate you all for tuning in. Let's hear it one more time for the cast of Bones. Let's hear it for Ignacio, Patricia, TJ, Eric, Tamara, and Michaela.
Yay. Thank you, Mike. Thanks for doing this with us.
Yeah, of course.
Thank
of course.
You, Mike.
Thanks, everybody. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Again, don't forget to check out our upcoming panels at wizardworldvirtual.com and at wizardworldvault.com. We got the cast of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air coming up this week. Talk about a show that I remember and love. Also, the cast of Blue Mountain State, Back to the Future, the old Escape to Witch Mountain movies. So we've got them all coming up. Follow us at Wizard World on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. My name is Mike G. You can follow me at Mike G Does Things if you want to submit those questions before each panel. And we've loved being here. So thanks again, and we'll see you next time.
Bye, you guys. I love you.
Bye.
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 Love you.
How do
we? Okay.